Good morning, Parkway.
Good morning.
It's so good to see everybody. Let's stand to our feet and let's worship the Lord together.
Sometimes on this journey, I get lost in my mistakes. What looks to me like weakness is a canvas for your strength. My story isn't over, no, my story's just begun. And failure won't define me, 'cause that's what my Father does. No, failure won't define me, 'cause that's what my Father does. Ooh, lay your burdens down. Ooh, here in the Father's house. Check your shame at the door, 'cause it ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, you're in the Father's house.
And arrival's not the end game, the journey's where you are. You never wanted perfect, you just wanted my heart. And the story isn't over if the story isn't good. Failure's never final if the Father's in the room. No, failure's never final if the Father's in the room.
Ooh, lay your burdens down. Ooh, here in the Father's house. Check your shame at the door, 'cause it ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, you're in the Father's house.
Prodigals come home, the helpless find hope. Love is on the move when the Father's in the room. Prison doors swing wide, the dead come to life. Love is on the move when the Father's in the room.
Miracles take place, the cynical find faith. Love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Jericho walls are breaking, strongholds now are shaking. Love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Oh, love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Ooh, lay your burdens down. Shame at the door, 'cause it ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, you're in the Father's house. Ooh, you're in the Father's house.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We welcome everybody here this morning. Like the song says, you need to check your shame at the door. If you're a prodigal, hey, this is the place you need to be. If you're sick, this is the right place to be. Because this is a hospital for the broken and the weary. Amen. So let's just take our time and worship the Father in the Father's house today. Let's lift up our hands to the Lord. Hallelujah. Father, in Jesus' name, we bless you. We honor you. We magnify you. We lift you up, Lord. We exalt you. You are the King of kings and the Lord of lords. And Father, yet you love us. Your grace overtakes us, Father. Your mercy and love overwhelm us. And we thank you for your love and mercy and grace. In Jesus' name, thank you, Father.
They say this mountain can't be moved. They say these chains will never break. But they don't know you like we do. There is power in your name.
Hallelujah.
We've heard that there is no way through. We've heard the tide will never change. They haven't seen what you can do. There is power in your name.
So much power.
So much power in your name. Move the immovable. Break the unbreakable. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. From the impossible, we'll see a miracle. God, we believe. God, we believe for it.
How many here this morning believe God for miracles? Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We know that hope is never lost, for there is still an empty grave.
Hallelujah!
God, we believe no matter what, there is power in your name.
So much power!
So much power in your name. Trust in you, God, you have the final say. You are the way when there seems to be no way. We trust in you, God, you have the final say. Move the immovable, break the unbreakable.
God, we believe.
God, we believe.
Yes, God, we believe.
God, we
from the impossible, we'll see a miracle. God, we believe.
God, we believe.
God, we believe for it. Move the immovable.
Break the unbreakable.
Break the unbreakable.
God, we believe.
God, we believe.
God, we believe.
God, we believe.
Hallelujah.
From the impossible, we'll see a miracle. God, we believe. God, we believe for it.
I'm here to testify today that God still does miracles. Amen. I've seen it with my own eyes. I've experienced it in my own life. I've experienced it in my own body. God still heals, God still saves, God still delivers, God still sets free. And I'm looking at so many people right now who can testify the same way. Hallelujah. Sister Marilyn Heichelback, you just said you went to the doctor the other day and he said 8 years cancer free. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God still does miracles today. So if you need a miracle today, or if you're trusting God for a miracle for someone else, I would just want to encourage you to hold on. Hallelujah. Hold on to God. Amen. Hallelujah.
You said it. I believe it. You said it. It is done. You said it. I believe.
I believe it.
You said it. It is done.
Come on and help me.
You said it.
Hallelujah.
I believe it.
I believe it.
You said it.
It is done. You said it. I believe it.
I believe it.
You said it. It is done. Move the immovable.
Voices, let's sing it together.
How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. All will see how great is our God.
How great is our God.
How great our God.
How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God.
Hallelujah. 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 For there is a greatness beyond measure, a greatness that cannot be contained, a greatness that cannot be fathomed. And I am that greatness. Therefore, look to me. Turn to me. Turn to me with all your hearts. Humble yourselves before me. Confess your sins. Confess your faults one to another. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and He will lift you up in due season. Today is the day that I am calling my people. I am calling you to a deeper sense of worship. I am calling you to deeper depths and to higher heights. I am calling you today to longer lengths and wider widths. I am calling you today to open your eyes to see me, to open your ears to hear my voice, to open your nostrils to breathe in the breath of life, to open your mouth to drink in the Holy Spirit. I am calling you today to recognize me, but not only recognize me, I am calling you today to give your love to me, so says the Lord. We believe in the gifts of the Holy Spirit. We believe that the Holy Spirit still speaks miraculously and supernaturally today. We believe in all of the gifts found in 1 Corinthians 11, 12, and 13. We believe in the gifts of tongues and interpretation of tongues and prophecy and word of wisdom, word of knowledge, healings, miracles. We believe in all of that. Do you believe that this was a word for you or for our congregation today? Would you just raise your hand and acknowledge that? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask us to just humble ourselves before the Lord this morning and to just call upon His name. Call upon His name. And I'm going to ask, as I often do, but I'm going to ask for us to lift up our voices. And I'm going to ask Denise to not play. And I'm going to ask us just to lift our voices to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords right now, and call upon the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's do that right now. Father, we call upon your name. We call upon your name, O God. Hallelujah. You are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. You are the everlasting Father. You are the Prince of Peace. There is none like you, O God. O Father, we call upon your name. Father, we call upon your name. Have your way in the midst of your people. Have your way in the midst of your church. Have your way in our lives. Have your way in this community. Have your way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we give ourselves to you. We give ourselves to you unreservedly. We surrender everything to you, Father. In Jesus' name, Father, we ask that you would have your way in our lives. Have your way in our church. Have your way in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now I want us to lift up a hand clap and a shout of praise that is fitting and appropriate for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we welcome you. We welcome you. We swing wide the gates and let the King of Glory come in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We welcome you. We welcome your presence. We welcome the presence and power of your Holy Spirit. We say, come, Lord Jesus. Come, Lord Jesus. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Praise God. Let's give him another hand clap and a shout of praise. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Well, it's already been good to have been in God's house today. Amen. Why don't you just turn around before you're seated and greet one another long distance and wave at somebody. Welcome him to God's house in Jesus' name. going to ask some of the prayer team to come forward. We're going to anoint Wanda with oil for healing. Some of the ladies to come forward. And maybe there's somebody else here who needs healing and needs to be anointed with oil this morning. Feel free to come forward at this time. Amen. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God of Israel, we anoint Miss Wanda with oil in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And Father, we come underneath the cleansing, healing blood of Jesus, the blood of the Lamb that has been shed. Hallelujah. Father, we just submit underneath the blood. Hallelujah. It's your blood that cleanses. It's your blood that washes. It's your wounds. By your wounds, we're healed. Hallelujah. And so we just come underneath the blood. Come underneath the blood of Jesus right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father. In Jesus' name, from the top of her head to the soles of her feet, make her completely whole, body, mind, soul, spirit, heart. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Have your way, have your way, have your way. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Have your way, have your way. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Father, we anoint Miss Jamesina with oil in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. By whose stripes we have already been healed. Hallelujah. Oh, we thank you, Father, for bringing her through so many valleys before. Hallelujah. And Father, we know that you're going to bring her through right now. Hallelujah. We thank you for what you've already done. We thank you for what you're doing right now. And we thank you, Father, for what you are going to do. Hallelujah. 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 In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, church, let's give God praise today. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. I believe that God still heals. I believe that God still delivers. I believe that God still sets free. I believe that God still saves. Hallelujah. 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 Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Let's give him praise, church. Let's give him praise. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want us to just intercede for Andrew Bird right now. He's got a procedure tomorrow. He's the head of our security team. Can we just agree together in prayer for him on his behalf right now? Father, in Jesus' name, we lift up Andrew Bird. And Father, we just first of all pray for the doctors and nurses and all those involved in this procedure. And Father, we just pray that your hand would be upon them and you would use them for your glory and for your honor. And Father, we just lift up Andrew and we just say in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, be healed. Father, we just pray in Jesus' name that this procedure would go completely well, that it would be a completely successful procedure with no harmful side effects to him in any way, only blessings and good things. Father, we just claim Psalm 91 over him, and we ask that you would send your holy angels to stand guard and stand watch over him during this procedure. And Father, that you would give him a speedy supernatural recovery in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God of Israel. Father, we know that he's going to the UT hospital, but Father, we know you've gone before him. Hallelujah. You've already gone before him. And Father, we know that you're going before him, behind him, above him, beneath him, all around him, within him, and you're going to work through him. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, church, let's just raise our hands to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Father, hallelujah. 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 Father, have your way. Oh, Father, We're hungry. We're hungry to see more of your manifestation. But Father, we're not just hungry for more of your manifestation. Father, we're hungry for you. We're hungry for you. We love you. We bless you. We praise you. We honor you. We magnify you. Hallelujah. 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 In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Let's go ahead and see the announcement video.
Good morning, Parkway family. I'm Chandra, your children's pastor.
I'm Lamar, your youth pastor.
And these are your morning announcements. We'd like to start off today by inviting everyone to join us next Sunday as we gather together to take communion.
We want to say a big thank you to everyone who stepped up to the plate and donated for our lighting and sound needs. Erica is currently putting all that together and making it all work. So we appreciate all her hard work, but we also appreciate you guys. So thank you.
We're so happy you joined us on this gorgeous, beautiful Sunday morning. We're so happy to be together in the house of the Lord. We'd also love to invite you to join us on Wednesday nights. The adults meet at 6:30 here in the sanctuary. They're going over that study on spiritual warfare. Upstairs, the Rooted Youth are meeting, as well as Ceiling Kids. And then after church in the basement, Deeper Roots meets.
In case you guys missed it, we started signups for the Dinner Theater last Sunday. The Dinner Theater is for Rooted Youth. This is for our youth group. This is to raise money for everything that we need for the year, for outings, for trips. We've got some big stuff planned, but we need the funds to do it. So this is our big fundraiser for the year. We've already started ticket sales last Sunday. We've already sold over 65 tickets. So if you're interested today, go ahead and sign up and pay for your tickets. If you want to buy a single ticket or if you want to buy a table, there is a price break if you buy a table, so you could buy a table. But ticket sales are going on today. Also,
and seating is limited. Seating is very limited. This is a one-night-only event, so do not wait.
Yes, that hints the desperation in my voice. Go ahead and sign up today if you're interested in coming. We're going to have a great show for you.
Also, with our wonderful Dinner Theater, we are doing the silent auction again. I know we had some questions about that. This silent auction is wonderful. You can do your Christmas shopping while you enjoy your dinner and a show. If you have donated, thank you. If you'd like to donate, we are accepting donations. I know that in the past years, people have said, why didn't you tell us? We would have loved to crochet you a blanket or something like that. Please do. We would love to have that. We would love to share that with our congregation. You can make your donations throughout the week. We need all donations by December 1st if you're going to be donating. And if you'd like to just stop by some small businesses, grab a letter on your way, and you can take those to get donations for us as well.
We will also be signing up for table decorations. We're going to have a table decorating contest. All of you ladies and gentlemen out there who are very creative and crafty, unlike some of us, please sign up to decorate a table. There'll be a grand prize for the winner. And also, we're doing a supply drive in the back. So come see us after service. We'll all be back there. But we'll have a supply drive back there. Things we need, cups, plates, things like that, that you can donate and just bring to church and put in the little wagon that's going to be there.
Yes, and our youth are so excited for this event. We have a new group this year. We've got several young ones, so our show is going to look a little different. It's definitely going to be more of a musical showcase, but they are so excited to share their talents with you. We've got such a musical group, and we are excited to do Dinner Theater a little different together with our church family.
I think that's all the announcements we have for you guys. We hope you have a wonderful service, and we hope to see you at the back table for tickets and all the signups for everything. Have a great service.
Bye,
bye guys.
Amen. I encourage everybody to stop by the table after the service. Well, this is the time when we bring our tithes and offerings to the Lord and thank Him for everything that He's done for us. Are you thankful today? Amen. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for all of your goodness and mercy and love and all of your grace. Father, we thank you, Father, for sending your Son Jesus, most of all, to be our Savior. Father, we thank you for the outpouring of your Holy Spirit. We thank you, Father, for giving us everything we have need of for life and godliness. We thank you, Father, for our daily bread. Father, we thank you. And Father, we want to do more than just do lip service with our thanksgiving, though. We want to give back to you out of the abundance which you've blessed us with. So, Father, we just give back our tithes and our offerings to you out of love for you. And, Father, we just do it for your glory and for your honor. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you as you give. Amen. Like they mentioned in the video, Eric has been so busy this week upgrading our lighting and sound, and she's just in the beginning stages of the process. But I think you can already hear it's better today, and we want to thank her for all of her hard work. Amen. If you'll open your bulletin, you can pull out the Parkway Church of God name submissions sheet. And these are all of the different names that you guys, my goodness, you're so creative. We've got on the front and on the back, I think it's 87 different name possibilities that you've submitted for our church. Our church is in the process, for those of you that are new today, our church is in the process of changing our name. And so this is a great response to our asking you to submit name possibilities. So this is a wonderful list to get us started, and the council's going to get it. It's going to start meeting right after this afternoon. We're going to meet and start the process of going through these names. So I just want to say thank you. Thank you for your response. Thank you for getting those creative juices going. Thank you for all of these wonderful possibilities that you have come up with for our new church name. And ultimately, though, it's not about what I want or about what you want. Ultimately, we just want a name that is pleasing to God and is pleasing to our congregation and lifts up the name of Jesus above all names. But we just want a name also that connects with our community. And so we want something that's pleasing to God, pleasing to our congregation, and pleasing to our community so that they can get connected to us. So thank you so much for your response today. By the way, for all of our first-timers today, I'm Pastor Philip Morris, and this is my wife, Denise. And we're so honored and privileged to be the pastor here at Parkway Church of God. And we're so glad that you're here. Parkway, let's welcome all of our first-timers today. Amen. If you don't mind, if you'll take the connection card that's in the back of the seat back in front of you and just write your name and info on that, please. We'd love to get to know you better. You can turn in that card at the tithe and offering table in the back, or you can just give it to me after service. I plan on being out in the lobby. I would love to get to meet you and get to know you a little bit. We're so honored that you have chosen to be with us today. And so thank you so much for being with us today. And by the way, I just want to welcome everybody who's joining us via live stream, via YouTube Live and Facebook Live. We're so glad that you're joining us today. Amen. Amen. All right. It's time for us to dive into the Word of God. Amen. Amen. So, Let's turn in our Bibles to Jeremiah 6:14. Jeremiah 6, verse 14, and this will get us started. And those of you that have electronic devices, you'll find Jeremiah 6:14. If you'll go ahead and find that, and that's going to be our launching pad today. But today, I'm kind of going in a different direction. As you know, we talked about last week starting a Celebrate Recovery ministry in our church. And I'm going to talk a little bit more about that at the end of the message. But I just felt led to start going through some of the basics and help us to be a real people. And what do I mean by that? Well, hopefully you'll know that at the end. Amen. But the title of the message is Living in Denial. Living in Denial. Living in Denial. Let's talk about the big lie. The big lie is that time heals all wounds. Time does not heal all wounds. How many nurses and other folk in here who are acquainted with the medical community, how many of you know that time does not heal all wounds? I hesitate to go into this, but my parents aren't listening, so it's okay for me to tell this story. When I was a teenager, I got into just about everything a teenager could get into. And I'm not going to go into all of that right now, but I was a PK. I was a preacher's kid, and they had a saying back when I was growing up. They said, preacher's kids are the... Well, how many of you all have heard that too, haven't you? Preacher's kids are the worst. And so I got into my fair share of trouble, and sometimes that involved wounds. And so I remember one time, well, more than one time, I think, but I remember specifically one time when I was a teenager, and I had an injury on my hand. And of course, I kept it well hidden from my parents so that they would not ask me why or when. Anybody else ever hidden anything from your parents? I didn't ask you to raise your hands. That's okay. That's okay. Hey, we've all done it. And I had an injury on my hand, and it wasn't getting any better. And it kept getting worse. Well, you know, that's what wounds do. Time does not heal all wounds. Time only makes it worse. The wounds fester. The infection spreads. The pain increases. So finally, I had enough, and so I decided to take care of this wound. Now, what I mean by taking care of this wound, and I'm not trying to gross anybody out, but I lit a match, and I disinfected a needle, and once that needle got good and hot, I used that needle to clean out my wound. Now, it hurt, as you can imagine. But I discovered once I stuck that wound with the needle that there was pus and everything else in that wound. In other words, it was actually worse than I thought it was. Sometimes the wounds that we face in life, we just keep pushing them down, just keep suppressing. It's going to be okay. But actually what's happening is the wounds are getting worse. And so I took that needle and I poked and prodded. And after about 3 days of doing that, I finally got the infection out, and it finally started to heal. How many of you know that a wound cannot heal while there's still infection? Now, it may scab over, pardon the terminology, it may scab over, but it's not really going to heal. Jeremiah 6, verse 14, let's read that together. They dressed the wound of my people as though it were not serious. Peace, peace, they say, when there is no peace. Or in the original language, shalom, shalom, they say, when there is no shalom. Now, this is talking about the people Israel, but I would like to take this verse and apply it to our lives today. How many wounds have we just dressed lightly but they're much more serious than how we're treating them? That's called denial. Denial. I'm okay. You're okay. We're all okay. Hey, look at us. We're all dressed up on a Sunday morning. We're all okay. Right? I'm okay. You're okay. We're all okay, right? Okay. But just because people say they're okay doesn't mean that they're okay. Many times, there's deep wounds, deeper than perhaps they're even willing to admit. Well, I'll put a Band-Aid on it. When Hope, my daughter, was young, and some of you guys remember that, she couldn't say some of her letters exactly right. And so she would, you know, something would get caught underneath of something or whatever, and she would have a pretend wound or a real wound. Who knows? We never really knew. And so she would come to me or come to Denise, and she would want two things. She'd say, I need a Band-Aid. A Band-Aid. I need a Band-Aid. And I want Daddy to anoint me with oil. So we would get her a Band-Aid. And I would anoint her with oil and pray for her. And that seemed to do the trick. She was off to her next thing. But when we grow up, some of us think that we're tough. Oh, I'm tough. It hasn't killed me. I just need to suck it up. I don't know if I'm supposed to say that in church or not. Well, it hasn't killed you yet. But how many of us know that there's many things that have happened during the COVID lockdowns? There have been many people suffering in loneliness. There's been many people who have unfortunately committed suicide, and their families are just surprised. They didn't realize how bad it was. And sometimes we have to realize how bad it is before we can address it. Because some of us are stubborn. I said some of us. I'm stubborn. Anybody else stubborn? I am asking you to raise your hand now. Okay. Oh, you can't point fingers. Marlene just pointed out Keith. She just called him out. So denial, I've got a little acrostic for you here. Denial is, the D stands for disables our feelings. The E stands for energy lost. The N stands for negates growth. The I stands for isolates us from God. The A stands for alienates relationships. And the L stands for lengthens the pain. Now, these aren't just little pop psychology things. I've got some scriptures to back it up. 2 Peter 2:19, for a man is a slave to whatever has mastered him. Hello. So many of us don't want to admit who's really in charge. Who's really in charge of our life? Now, if you ask me and Denise, who's really in charge of our marriage and our home, hopefully we would say, I'm the king and she's the queen. And I treat her like a queen, and she treats me like a king. And I don't make any major decision without asking for input from my queen. And my queen does not entertain anything unless she receives input. Thank you. Input from the king. Now, I'd like to say that that's usually the case. Sometimes, though, either she or I have gone off and made a decision without the input from one another, and I would say that we've both heard that that is not appropriate from the other party. But why do I say that? Because who is in charge is important. Who is really in charge in your life? Oh, Jesus! Jesus is in charge of my life. Okay, let's prove it. Let's put you on the witness stand and review your daily habits for the last year. Now, Pastor, let's be real. Who is really in charge of your life? Let's go to Psalm 146, verse 7. Yahweh sets prisoners free. He sets prisoners free. But what happens when Father God Yahweh comes to the jail cell that we're in and tries to set us free, and we say, hey, I'm good. You don't need to set me free. In fact, I've got 3 meals a day in here. Got a place to sleep. I'm doing all right. So I'm good, God. I don't need to be set free from this prison. Do you realize how warped that really is? When you could be on the outside enjoying your freedom, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty, amen. He whom the Son sets free is free indeed. You could be on the outside living your life of freedom, but you choose to live in denial and to live a prisoner. Psalm 107, verse 13. Then they cried to Yahweh in their trouble, and he saved them from their distress. But how many of you know that you don't really cry out to Yahweh in your trouble if you don't think you're in trouble? In other words, if you're just suppressing and denying and I'm okay, you're okay, I got a Band-Aid on it. It's all okay. It's okay. So you're never really crying out to Yahweh from your trouble. So Yahweh really never saves you from your distress. You see, that's the beginning point of worship. Surrender. Surrender. This week has been Veterans Week, and I've watched several programs about our veterans on TV. And the saddest thing is when they showed pictures of our veterans surrendering to an enemy army. But that's the happiest thing about us surrendering to the Lord. We begin our worship at the point of surrender. You can't really worship until you've surrendered. Amen. So Psalm 107 verse 14 says, He brought them out of darkness and the deepest gloom and broke away their chains. Well, Pastor, you don't know what I've done. You don't know where I've been. You don't know who all I've been involved with. And I don't think there's any way out of this mess. Well, I don't say this lightly, and I don't say this as just a statement, but I really believe that God can bring you out of darkness and the deepest gloom. The deepest gloom. Where there's not a lick of light anywhere. Where everything is darkness. Hey, God specializes in rescuing people from the darkness. That's His specialty. So don't rule Him out. He can still save you. He can still rescue you. He can still deliver you. He can still set you free. He can still heal you. God is a God who delivers people from the darkness. Amen. 1 John 1:5. God is light. In Him there is no darkness at all. Wow. God is light. And in Him there is no darkness at all. When I preached my first message at Lee College, now Lee University, it was in a chapel, and Denise was in charge of that chapel, and her group asked me to speak. And I'm amazed that some people still today remember the illustration that I used for that message, and I thought it was really appropriate for today. You know, do you know the origin of the word sincere? Sincere? Like someone is really sincere. In the original language, that word means without wax. Without wax. And what the statue makers of those days would do, they would carve statues. And then whenever they kind of missed their mark and there was a chip or something in their statue, they would fill it in with wax. So when the sun would get hot and the sun would shine on that statue, that wax would start to melt, and whoever had bought that statue would realize that they've gotten something a little faulty. Well, I want us to consider something today. We can't use wax to cover up our past, our present. We can't use wax. That's just denial. We can't keep on denying that we need help. But the next verse, 1 John 1:6, if we claim to have fellowship with him, yet walk in the darkness, we lie and do not live by the truth. In other words, we're a bunch of liars if we claim to have fellowship with him, yet walk in the darkness. So what does that mean? That means that we need to come out of the darkness. We need to come out of the darkness. We need to come clean. We don't live by the truth when there's wax. When we use wax, we're lying. But if we claim to have fellowship with him, yet walk in the darkness, we lie and do not live by the truth. Now, what's it talking about darkness right there? Let's go to the next verse, 1 John 1:7. But if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his son, cleanses us, purifies us from all sin. So we need to come clean with our past. We need to come clean with what we're doing right now. And we need to come clean. And we need to get it all under the blood. All under the blood of Jesus. And allow him to cleanse us and wash us and purify us. We don't need to live in denial. Ephesians 4:25 says, putting off the lie. We should put off the lie and embrace the truth. Even if the truth hurts. Even if the truth is somewhat embarrassing. But we need to come clean. Last week I shared with my struggle with pornography, and I was a fourth grader and was exposed to pornography on a regular basis without the knowledge of my parents. You know, there's a key theme here, without the knowledge of my parents. So what I was hiding from my parents was in the darkness. Anybody ever been there? So I was hiding stuff from my parents. And those things that I hid from my parents later took over my life. Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 17. I love this verse. But I will restore you to health and heal your wounds, declares Yahweh. Now again, this verse is talking about his people Israel. But I like to appropriate this verse for me because I've been grafted in. Hallelujah. I've been grafted in by the blood of Jesus, and I've been grafted into Israel. And so I appropriate this verse for me. And so I'm going to share this verse again, Jeremiah 30:17. But I will restore you to health and heal your wounds, declares Yahweh. Heal your wounds. That is what God wants. God doesn't want to beat you up over everything that you've done wrong. Now, if you keep ignoring those things, he will come up with some very interesting ways to help you to come clean. Hello? We've all been there. God knows how to get a hold of us, and he knows how to expose what needs to be exposed. But God's desire is to restore us to health. And to heal our wounds, whether they're physical wounds, mental wounds, spiritual wounds. It doesn't matter what type of wounds. God wants us to be healed and to be whole and to be healthy. And so today, that's the question that I'm asking. And I'm not asking you to raise your hands right now. How many of us in here are really healthy and healed? And how many in here have just squashed it, put it down, and we're living in denial? Like I said, I shared my testimony last week. And I would like to have different people from our church congregation to share their testimonies in future Sundays. In fact, I would love to just get little two to three minute sound bites or video bites. And I would love us to be able to post them on the internet, on our church website, or our church Facebook page. I would love for everyone to consider sharing your testimony, like we talked about last week. The mess that God brought you through, it can become your message. The test that God brought you through can become your testimony. So I would love to have so many people in our congregation, because we don't often get to hear from one another in this setting. And I'd like to get some people who will share their testimony and be willing to do that. And so what I've done is I've asked Robbie Sweet to come right now, and I've asked him to share his testimony this morning. And I believe that you'll be blessed as he shares this morning.
The entire service has been a perfect segue for me to actually speak by the term and the definition of the term miracle. And so by Webster's Dictionary, the definition of miracle, give me just a second, I'm popping it up. An effect of extraordinary event in the physical world that surpasses all human or natural powers and ascribes to a supernatural cause. I believe it opens up the door for 1 Corinthians 1:27. It says that he has put the foolish things of this earth to confound the wise. Every person in here is a miracle, I being one of them. I was raised in church, but I was shown the religious side of Pentecost. Not knowing what the future would hold, I entered in the adolescence of my freshman year in high school. Many questions were never answered pertaining to religion. I was interested in creation and how it began. The only answer was evolution. So I indulged myself with the evolutionary thought that this possibly could be the truth, which turned into a lie. So from the ages of 18 to 28, I believed this lie right off the bat. In the midst of that 18 to 28, I involved myself with the sex, drugs, and rock and roll lifestyle, because I was a musician. Hey, why not? Then one night, after pulling a two-day drunk from March 17th to March 19th, I was standing on the edge of a cliff March 19th, exactly at 10:30 at night, almost committed suicide. I said, Jesus, if you're real, you're going to have to reveal yourself. I didn't get the words echoed out of my mouth, and my phone rang, and my dad, thank God for a praying dad, he felt the urgency to call me. He says, I don't know where you're at. I don't care. I need to pray for you right now. So October 14th, 8 months later, is when I found myself in church for the very first time in over, I guess, 13 years. And I gave my life to Christ because it was a church singing. I felt warm honey following over me. And then so now I have dedicated the things that have attacked me when I was at a young age, in those adolescence, I'm beginning to attack. So being said, parents, watch what your kids are watching. Grandparents, watch what your kids are listening. That includes inside the school system as well, because I was indoctrinated with it. So my point is, this thing is real. Don't try to tell me otherwise. And if I could go back and tell that kid, hey, this thing is real, I would in a heartbeat. So, Mr. Mables, you were wrong. And I hate saying that, because it's the truth. The truth is, evolution is a lie, and that's what integrated me. So mixed in with religion, mixed in with evolution, birth, my atheistic experience, which almost led me to commit suicide. And now I've dedicated my life to this. And you will read about it one day when I publish my book. My book is done. I'm just looking for an author. So help me pray for this author. I'm not author, but publisher to put this thing out there for kids that is integrated with this stuff inside the school systems. So parents, it's your time now.
Amen. So Robbie was an atheist. And then he gave his heart to Jesus. And later he ended up getting his GED. And then he started on his bachelor's degree. And now he's almost done with his bachelor's degree. And he's planning on going on for higher education. And the subject of his studies is the Word of God. And amen. So I'm just going to say this. I'm extremely proud of Robbie. Amen. Thank you, Robbie. Amen. So catastrophe was averted that night when Robbie was standing on the precipice getting ready to jump off. And he said, Jesus, if you're real, you're going to have to show yourself. And immediately his dad called at 10:30 at night and said that he felt compelled to call Robbie. And Robbie stepped back from the brink. Maybe there's someone here today who is on the brink. Maybe there's someone here today who's on the cusp. We've heard during these COVID lockdowns that there's been an extraordinary number of veterans who have taken their own life. But I am the voice of God today, and I don't say that lightly, but hear the voice of God today. You don't have to give up. God has a plan for your life. In fact, He has a plan, a purpose, a destiny, a calling on your life that is above and beyond anything that you can even think or imagine. So don't listen to the lie. The lies always dwell in the shadows. Don't listen to the lie. Listen to the truth. God is wanting to set you free. God is able to set you free. So don't jump off the cliff. Step back from the precipice today and hear the voice of God speaking in your ear and acknowledge Him as your Savior, your Lord, the leader of your life. Amen. Other people right in this room and perhaps listening, watching via live stream, other people are closer to the brink than you realize. Stress has been unimaginable these last couple of years. And you've been on the brink, whether you want to admit it or not. Perhaps you're one of those who are living in denial. But let me tell you something today. Jesus is a specialist at shining His light into the darkness. He can make a way where there seems to be no way. He can turn over whatever tables are facing you today and he can rescue you and save you and deliver you and set you free. Now, it may not be instantaneous. It may be a long process. Some people seem to get delivered overnight, and some people, it takes a long time. But whichever way is God's way for you, I just want to encourage you today that he is able. Hallelujah. Can we say that together? He is able. Come on, one more time. He is able. Hallelujah. He can set you free. Hallelujah. So I told you all that I would be talking about the Celebrate Recovery at the end of the message. I've asked everyone to pray about this new ministry that we're getting, hopefully getting ready to start here on Monday nights. And I've asked you all to pray about it during November. I'm not going to do sign-ups today. Did I mention that I'm not going to do sign-ups today? I'm not going to do sign-ups today. We're going to do sign-ups in December. And our first planning and training meeting will be Monday, January 10th at 6 p.m. We'll probably order in pizza or something like that and begin our training process and planning process at that point. But why am I sharing that now? Because I need some people who are willing to get real. Next slide. Who are willing to get real. Who are willing to get real with their past. Who are willing to get real about sharing their past. Now, Robbie overcame that fear of sharing his past in the setting here amongst religious people. Now, why did Robbie overcome his fear? Because his fear was based on religion, not based on relationship. So when Robbie overcame the spirit of religion, which condemns people, and entered into the spirit of relationship, which wants to love people and to heal people, then Robbie was delivered to be able to share his testimony because he knew that this Parkway congregation loved him. That needs to be the story with every single person that walks into this building. We need to overwhelm them with the love and mercy and grace of Almighty God. God didn't make us to be... I shouldn't say it. Pharisees that condemn people and pretend that they've got it all together. If you've got it all together, I'd like to meet with you after service because I'd like to get some advice from someone who's got it all together. So we need to quit pretending that we've got it all together. We've got to get real. And when we get real and love people where they are, love them to Jesus. Hey, when we are willing to get real with where people are and love them to Jesus, then we'll find the freedom to overcome whatever fears have kept us in bondage. Because there's some of us who've been kept in bondage, whether we realize it or not. There's some of us who are in bondage to fear. When I was in seminary, they asked me to write out my testimony. Imagine that. At a Christian seminary, asking a student to write out his testimony. It's a Pentecostal seminary. Pentecostal Theological Seminary is the name of it now. And so that was part of what we had to do. And when I got to the part of my testimony where I thought about sharing about the struggle with pornography, I pulled the pen back. I pulled the pin back. And I said, I don't know about this. I don't know if I can trust these people. I don't know if I can trust my professor. I don't know if I can. You understand? You hear the way that I was responding? I don't know. I don't know if I can trust. I don't know if I can trust them. But I took the plunge, and I wrote it in my testimony. And you know what? That is often the part of my testimony that people come up to me afterwards and talk to me about, either because they've been set free themselves, or they're struggling themselves, or they know someone who's struggling themselves. You understand? So when I share that part of my testimony, people understand that I'm not perfect, but God is. Hallelujah. God has made a way for me. God has made a way for you. God has made a way for all of us. And when we get real, that will change the atmosphere of this congregation, and this will be a congregation that is overwhelming with the love and mercy and grace of Almighty God. Is that your heart's cry for this congregation? I am asking you to raise your hands now. Is that your heart's cry? Amen. Are you willing to get real? I'm glad three of you are. Are you willing to get real and experience the love and mercy and grace of Almighty God? I'm going to ask you to take it a step further. If you're willing to get real and for this to be a congregation that gets real, would you stand to your feet all over this room? All over this room. God has set me free, and He can set you free as well. Now, what I'm going to ask for us to do is think back to the mess. Think back to the test. We've all experienced it at some point or another. Think back to the mess. Think back to the test. Has that mess become your message? That mess that God has brought you through, has that become your message? That test that God has brought you through, has that become your testimony? If not, God can cause that to become your testimony, can cause that to become your message, if you'll only yield that area of your life to Him. So now I'm going to ask us to do something that may be even a little more uncomfortable. I'm going to ask us if we're really willing to get real. We're really willing to put off the lie. If we're really willing to walk in the light of the forgiveness of the blood of Jesus, if we're willing to no longer hide in the shadows, if we're willing to no longer live in denial, if you're willing today to allow your test to become your testimony, to allow your mess to become your message and be used of God, if you're ready to get real, would you come forward and join me at the front, and let's pray a prayer of dedication before we leave. Amen. 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 Let's just raise our hands and surrender to Him and ask Him to do His work His way. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank You for this opportunity that You've given us today to testify of Your goodness, to testify of Your grace, to testify of Your mercy, to testify of Your love. Oh, Father, we thank You that You have already saved us from the uttermost. And Father, today we are choosing as a congregation. We are choosing to get real. We are choosing in Jesus' name to be an authentic congregation, an authentic testimony of what Jesus has done in each and every one of our lives. Oh, Father, we're asking in Jesus' name that You will strip away the denial. And Father, no matter how painful it is, like when I took that needle and stuck it in my hand, it was so painful, but it was so necessary. Father, I pray in Jesus' name that You would do whatever surgery is necessary to cause us to walk in the health and the wholeness and the healing of body, mind, soul, spirit, and heart that is necessary. And Father, I pray that You would not just do that work right here, but Father, that that work would begin to overflow in us and overflow through us and to flow out into our community and to reach all those around us, Father, who are broken and are hurting and are just not willing to admit it. But Father, the convicting power of Your Holy Spirit can seize their hearts and stop them in their tracks. And Father, they can come to themselves and return to the Father's house. And Father, they can be healed. They can be made whole. Oh, Father, I pray in Jesus' name that You would use us for Your glory and for Your honor, that You would use us to share our times of brokenness, to use us to share our times of testing, to use us to share our times even when You brought us through a mess. And Father, that You would confirm that work in each and every one of our hearts and lives so that each and every one of us can have a testimony. Hallelujah. Have a testimony of how God brought us through. Oh, Father, I pray in Jesus' name that You would have Your way in us and through us for Your glory and for Your honor. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's give God praise. So I would like to just close with my normal greeting. But I'm not saying it in the way that Jeremiah 6:14 said it. They dressed the wound of My people as though it were not serious. Shalom, shalom, they say, when there is no peace. I'm going to say it in a way that invites in the healing and the health and the wholeness from Almighty God, the shalom of Almighty God, the peace that passes all understanding, that guards our hearts and minds. That's the way that I want to say it. I don't want to live in denial. I want to live in victory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I'm going to say that. I'm going to make this a declaration. We have been healed. We are healed. We will be healed in Jesus' name. Shalom. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. God bless you all. I love you.
Through You, I can do anything. I can do all things. Positive.